Hello guys, how are you today? And today I will be doing a review of Chowder.
You take the moon and you take the sun.
You take everything that seems like fun. You stir it all up and then you're done.
Now, when you usually think of Chowder, you actually think of the food. No, it's actually a TV series. I first saw this show when I was like 7, back in 2007 when it first aired. It was actually my favorite show, and this is why I made a review on it, and I miss it again. They made 49 episodes, and I just want to share my opinions on it. The show was created by C.H. Greenblatt, who actually, he worked on SpongeBob, and he worked on The Grim Adventures of Billy Mandy. Right now, he's doing a production for Fishhooks. But right now, I'm going to talk about the characters, mostly right now. The first character is Chowder. Chowder, which is the main character of the show, is a cat, bear, rabbit. The reason why I say that is he's a mix of a cat, a bear, and a rabbit. Basically it. He is basically fat because he likes to eat things. He is very, very, he's 12 year old. But like he eats so much and I don't really get it. Why doesn't he get like really, really fat? But I'm not really here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about Chowder. But Chowder is one of those easygoing person. He wants to become a big chef like Mong Dol, which is something that I would not want to do. I don't know, it's just Chowder. But basically, he lives in this place called Marzipan City. Does he have any love interests? No, because, well, until the last episode when he grows up. He does have this one character that actually likes him, but he usually uses the term, "I'm not your boyfriend," to this girl named Panini. Panini is the same as Chowder in his species. He is a cat, bear, rabbit thing, but her love interest is Chowder, which for some reason I like because I have a love problem in my life. Panini is basically always wants to marry Chowder, and usually, you know, she wants to have so many babies with her, which in the final episode I thought was just so freaking understanding. And but when I saw the babies, I was just like, what? Because like she had a lot of them. Panini likes Chowder a lot, and if any girl around her that likes him as a friend or anything, she gets totally jealous. As in one of season 3's episodes, which was actually the final season. To be honest, Panini is a good character on the show. I do have to be honest. Chowder is also my favorite character, so I don't care if there's any. I don't care. They're both my favorite characters. I don't care. Basically, I would like Panini, and this is why I really want the show back. I mean, it's not the only thing, though, but Panini is basically one of those characters, like, she's, like, perfect. She's not like Amy from Sonic, or she's not like any of those other freaking cartoons or shows. She's basically another type of character, and I really like her because of that. If you're wondering who Chowder's master is and why he wants to become a great chef, it is Chef Mong Dol. He is Chowder's cooking master. He is, I don't know his age, but it's really old. So I guess no one in Chowder really actually dies. But Mong Dol is an easygoing man, but, you know, can be sometimes crazy sometimes. He is a great master chef. He's been cooking for 100 some years, 200 some years. And he's basically good with the ladies, man. Which, yeah. Other than that, I really do like Mong Dol. And I know this background's kind of creepy of Mong Dol, but you know what? I don't care. It's not creepy to me. But anyway, Mong Dol is actually a really, really sarcastic person. Well, basically in the later episodes. in other episodes, he's like your normal chef, but then he goes a little sarcastic and he gets a little, you know, a little bit other stuff. He is actually my third favorite character on the show, but, you know, I just really, I don't care. After three favorite characters, I don't think there's actually other favorite characters. But anyways, another thing about Dole is that he basically, you know, he has another assistant manager. It says on the Wikipedia that he's a master chef. But he has this assistant in the kitchen that he makes it do all the work. And his name is Schnitzel. Schnitzel is basically a rock monster that serves as a, I guess in the Wikipedia, he's a master chef, but he usually cleans. So basically call him a rock monster janitor. Basically, Schnitzel, what Schnitzel does is work from one adult and cleans up all his messes. He usually doesn't like how Mong and Chowder really, you know, act and stuff, because it usually gets him in a lot of trouble. But he usually comes through for them in times of need for them. As in one time, when Schnitzel quits and works for Endot. Which, actually, that's all I have to say for Schnitzel. And if you want to know who Endive is, well, Endive, let's just say, I actually really don't know what Endive is. I guess he's like a monster kind of thing that likes Schnitzel and is actually the master of Panini. Endive and Mong Dole have actually like a rivalry, but what were you expecting? What were you expecting from two master chefs? But she's a woman, and I don't have any problem with that, but because women are really good at cooking. Some of them are not, some of them are. What I'm trying to say is that Endive is a person that gets really mad at times. And sometimes in the show, for some reason, you can notice she can get bigger without notice. She doesn't actually do a transformation or anything. She just gets bigger. It's just weird. I have no idea what causes this. Maybe it's because of her anger. But I don't know. Endive is basically fat and not really good to look at. Which is the reason why she had a boyfriend. But wait. Why are we talking about Endive? We should be talking about Truffles. We should be what? Now, Truffles is Mungdol's wife. Like Endive, she can get angered really, really, like, she can get really easily. To be honest, Truffles and Endive would be a good match, actually, if they were, you know, lesbians. She can be really nice or she can be really mad. Basically, all the time she's really mad. She usually yells a lot. And in one episode, she tried to cure that with just one monocle, but she found out that that couldn't cure anything. And basically, that's why she's still the loudmouth old woman. Actually, I just found out that this character is actually based on her on CH Green Blast mom. Yes, but what other person have you seen that acts like this? But anyway, yeah, basically, Truffles is, be nice. She can be mad, but, you know, she'll be my, fourth favorite character out of the show. I'm sorry if I don't like Schnitzel because of his rod, 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 because, also, by the way, Schnitzel also just thinks it's rod, rod, rod. And if you're wondering, enough about Truffles, if you're wondering why don't I have clips of the show, except the intro, is because the show, many of the clips on YouTube have been flagged, I mean, well, copyright lawed, they should have been copyright laws, and also because I'm too lazy to look at the actual clips that you'll see in the description. You can actually watch all the episodes on the internet, which I gave a link in the description. But one thing I want to clear up right now is the clothes of Chowder. What they do with is get a wallpaper, and like put the wallpaper image on the clothes, and like it moves with the clothes. It doesn't do like a character and like it stays in one place. No, it actually moves. And I actually kind of liked that Chowder. But basically, yeah. Anyways, I want to give you some other things about the show that I like. Basically, the show breaks the fourth wall a lot of times in the show. I'm not going to do it so many times because sometimes Chowder just says, "We're in a cartoon." In that one episode that Chowder actually ate some stuff that made him smart, and basically he changed the whole freaking show, basically destroying it as well. Basically the show basically breaks the fourth wall. That's not the only reason. The show makes me feel comfortable in the mood. Every time I watch this show, I was like, "Oh my God, yes, this will make me feel, you know, not depressed," because sometimes I feel dormant, which is depressed, but you know, sometimes I just love this show. I love this show. It is a great entertainment for kids, basically, but not grown-ups, because you know how grown-ups want to watch their live-action stuff, which I actually like now. Yeah, but don't watch that Disney crap. Fish Hooks is nothing compared to Chowder. I would expect SpongeBob SquarePants or The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy to be close to Chowder. Fish Hooks is nothing that I like. If you like Fish Hooks, then that's fine. But I really, in my opinion, I do not like Fish Hooks. I used to actually like the show, but it just went out of the mood for me. If you like a show where crazy things going on, then go watch Chowder. It actually still premieres on Cartoon Planet on Fridays, which is a letdown because I think it was gonna come back. Like, one of my friends told me that after the big movie of Ed and Eddie that they were gonna come back, but they never did, and I was disappointed. I would basically think that Chowder is not coming back. There's a big letdown to you all, you Chowder fans, and I've actually looked up a lot of Chowder videos on YouTube, and a lot of them said they say this is their favorite show, and I have to agree with them. This is my favorite show of far as so far. I mean, it reuses jokes at times, but you know, it's fun to watch the show, even if it's not funny at times. But yeah, guys, this has been my review of Chowder. I know I didn't do that good with this review because this is actually my first review of any TV series or anything in general. But yeah, I hope you like this review when Chowder gets a 10 out of 10. Good night. Hey!